Good morning, Lancaster Catholic.
I'm Maggie Boyle.
And I'm Chris Richards.
Today is Wednesday, November 14th, A-Day, and here's what you need to know.
Today's lunch is spicy chicken legs, buttered pasta, steamed veggies, and fruit.
Monday's Sea of Blue Dress Sunday was a huge success. We raised over $1,500. All of the money will be donated to help the veterans in a variety of ways. For those of you that dressed down but forgot $3, you can take your donations to Mr. Sharp in room 217.
Also, seniors, graduation stationery packets are due today. So if you want your order to be submitted, be sure to get it to Mr. Sharp before the end of the day.
Tri-M Music Honor Society members are reminded to turn in your community service project forms no later than this Friday.
FMLA has asked all classes to pitch in and help them put together gift baskets for needy families with premature babies. Freshmen are asked to bring in baby blankets, sophomores, diapers, juniors, baby lotion, and seniors, onesies. All donations will be donated to the NICU. A prize will be given to the class with the highest participation.
FBLA meets tomorrow during first crusader period. Fundraiser packets will be available for distribution. Mr. Sharp has asked us to remind you to have your competitive event ready for the meeting.
Tomorrow is your last chance to bring in any canned goods, as Respect Life homeroom representatives will be collecting boxes for the Thanksgiving food drive. All donations are greatly appreciated.
Mrs. Wentz is asking all Respect Life members to report to room 208 during study hall and crusader period to help sort the boxes.
The death toll rises to 44 in the California wildfires that continue to burn out of control. More than 7,000 homes and over 200,000 acres were destroyed by the inferno. Here's Gretchen and Allie to fill you in.
Malibu, the home of many celebrities, is among the hardest hit areas. Miley Cyrus tweeted that her house is gone, but her loved ones and pets made it out safely, so she's grateful. Gerard Butler wrote that his Malibu home is in ruins, and he's heartbroken for other Californians who lost everything. According to CBS News, more than 200 people are missing, and the fire areas are too dangerous for searchers to try and find them.
CNN is suing President Trump and several of his aides for yanking the press credentials of White House chief correspondent Jim Acosta. The lawsuit claims Acosta's First Amendment rights were violated and it wants the press pass restored. The White House took it away after last week's confrontation during a press briefing.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas in New York City. The famous Rockefeller Center Christmas tree arrived this past Saturday morning. The towering Norway spruce came from a farm in upstate New York. The tree lighting ceremony is November 28th.
Lancaster's Christmas tree has also arrived. A family in Mannheim donated the Norway spruce. It will be the centerpiece of the tree lighting ceremony in Penn Square next Friday night.
Bruno Mars is getting in the spirit of the holiday season. At the end of his world tour in Honolulu, the singer announced he's partnering with the Salvation Army to feed 24,000 of his fellow Hawaiians in need.
Comic book author Stan Lee has died at age 95. You may not know his name, but you sure know his creations. He gave life to iconic Marvel superheroes like Spider-Man, Iron Man, the X-Men, Incredible Hulk, Black Panther, and of course, all of the Avengers. I'm Allie McCormick.
And I'm Gretchen Burtz.
Allie and Gretchen mentioned Christmas trees. Well, for Catholic High, Santa Claus is coming to town. Breakfast with Santa is right around the corner, and Santa needs helpers. See Mrs. Christensen or Mrs. Remrick if you are interested. This is a fun and easy way to get some service hours.
There's been a strange sighting in the sky. Arya Yang has the story.
Do you believe in UFOs and aliens? I do. And astronomers from Harvard University do too. Last year in Hawaii, a mysterious cigar-shaped object was spotted tumbling through our solar system. It has a Hawaiian nickname, Aumuamua, meaning a messenger that reaches out from the distant past. Recently, astronomers found that the object is not from nature, but made. According to Harvard researchers, Aumuamua may be a fully operational probe sent intentionally to Earth by an alien civilization. And it is the first object ever seen in our solar system that is known to have originated elsewhere. I'm Arya Young.
Here's your chance to make it in the yearbook. Bring your furry friend to room 121 next Tuesday, November 20th, between 3:30 and 6:30 to get your picture taken. Make sure to wear your uniform.
We will see a preview of the fall play, Murders in the Air, later today. To see the entire show, buy our tickets now. Performances are Thursday, Friday, and Saturday.
Winter sports athletes, make sure to get your PIAA certification form in by this Friday, or else you won't be allowed to practice.
And finally, if your birthday is today, you share it with actor Josh Duhamel. He appears in the chick flick Safe Haven and the action-packed film Transformers. Duhamel was married to famous singer Fergie for 8 years.
Have a great day, Crusaders!